Praise the Lord. Today let's look at the third commandment. Remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. Exodus chapter 20 verse 8 to 12 states, Remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. 6 days you may labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. No work may be done then either by you or your son or daughter, or your male or female slave, or your beast, or by the alien who lives with you. In 6 days, the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them. But on the seventh day, he rested. That is why the Lord has blessed the Sabbath day and made it holy. After God parted the Red Sea and led the Israelites out of Egypt, He gave Moses the Ten Commandments on stone tablets. This shows how important they are that he wrote them on stone so they could be preserved and remembered. The third commandment is, remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. It sounds straightforward, but what does it actually mean to put it into practice? When miners are mining underground for coal, trains transport the coal underground before it is brought up to the surface. How were the wagons of coal pulled underground before the days of the locomotive or engines? Mules or donkeys were used. A visitor was traveling through the coal-rich area more than 100 years ago, asked why there were so many donkeys grazing in the fields around the coal pits. The answer was that the donkeys work underground for 6 days a week and are brought to the surface every Sunday. If they were not brought to the surface one day a week, they would go blind. The donkeys needed to come to the surface one day a week, or else they would go blind. One of the ways in which we could go blind now is forgetting that there are things in life more important than money, job, career. We could be so busy working and earning money that we are blind to spending enough time together. We could be so intent on making money that we needlessly work 7 days a week like those donkeys. We too need to rest one day a week to prevent us from going blind in many ways. There is a saying, all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. It is good to relax, to get away from it all, to take rest, to go on holidays, to go on a retreat, to take exercise. We can only work well if we are taking proper rest. In the gospel, the Pharisees were blind to Jesus being master of the Sabbath. Mark chapter 2 verse 28, So the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath. Their interpretation of the law of Moses had led them into error, so that they became so obstinate when Jesus healed on the Sabbath. Mark chapter 3 verse 5, He looked around at them with anger. He was grieved at their hardness of heart, and he said to the man, stretch out your hand. He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. This was done on a Sabbath. It was as if Jesus was now leading them to the surface to see with the real light of God. But alas, they were resisting. Jesus really was Lord of the Sabbath, because in the new covenant, the holy day changed from Saturday, the Sabbath, to Sunday, the Lord's Day. When Paul wrote to the Corinthians, it was being fulfilled. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 6, for it is the God who said, let light shine of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. Jesus is the Son of God. But as a Jew, he kept all the commandments. Anything considered work that he did on the Sabbath was to heal people and share the good news. He did not do labor. The Catechism of the Catholic Church, CCC 2175, explains how for Christians, Sunday takes the place of the Sabbath of the Old Testament. It says Sunday is expressly distinguished from the Sabbath, which it follows chronologically every week. For Christians, its ceremonial observance replaces that of the Sabbath in Christ's Passover. In Christ's Passover, Sunday fulfills the spiritual truth of the Jewish Sabbath and announces man's eternal rest in God. For worship under the law prepared for the mystery of Christ and what was done there prefigured some aspects of Christ. Those who lived according to the old order of things have come to a new hope, no longer keeping the Sabbath but the Lord's day, in which our life is blessed by Him and by His death. This means that Christ and the celebration of the Mass on the Lord's Day is our focus as Catholics. One day a week has been given to us by God for rest. It is a day when we pull back from our normal activities, a day when we spend time with other people, and a day when we spend time with God. It is a day when many people do works of mercy, such as visiting the sick. Of all the things that we do on Sunday, celebrating the Eucharist together as a community is the most important. It is the highlight of our week, the most important hour of our week. Jesus said, "Do this in memory of me." Luke chapter 22 verse 19 and 1 Corinthians 11 24. And so we gather every Sunday to meet Jesus in the Eucharist. God calls us to Himself individually, but also calls us to Himself as His body, members of the Church. That is why we gather as a parish every Sunday to celebrate the Eucharist. We are answering God's call to worship, praise and honor Him. Those who say they pray in their own way at home on Sunday do not have the Eucharist at home, do they? And yet, Jesus said to celebrate the Eucharist in memory of Him. Sunday is a day when we remember that we are on this planet for just a short few years and that we are here to prepare for eternal life. Every Sunday is meant to be a foretaste of heaven, because every Sunday is meant to be a day of rest, a day devoted to God. Sunday is a day when we remember that we are not just bodies, but that we are body and soul. We are hopefully nourishing our souls every day, but we do so above all through our Sabbath Eucharist. When God speaks His word to us in the scripture reading, when we receive God's love for us in the Eucharist, it is a day to remember that we are just passing through this life. It is a reminder that there is a spiritual side to each of us and that we cannot expect to be fully happy if we do not feed our souls. It is obvious that we are living in a time when there is less and less respect for anything religious, and there are less people celebrating the Eucharist together. And with this pandemic, after the church is open, we do not know how it is going to be. Because we are getting so used to having the Eucharist online, in the comfort of our homes, at our own convenient time. But if we don't have God in our lives, what value do our lives have anymore? Just think that the greatest miracle that takes place in your local parish church every Sabbath, when bread becomes the body of Jesus for you. Jesus died on Calvary for you, and the grace of Calvary is offered to you anew in every Mass. Words cannot describe the gift of beauty or holiness of the Holy Eucharist. Words cannot describe the love of God available to each of us in every Eucharist. If ever we complain about the Eucharist, it shows that we have not yet grown to understanding the love of God for us in the Mass. Try to go more in understanding of the love of God for you in every Eucharist, every time you celebrate the Eucharist. This Sunday when I was celebrating Mass online, the priest was explaining the different parts of the Eucharist. Over the last few weeks he has been doing that. And yesterday he said at the time of the consecration, the epiclesis, when the Holy Spirit comes down and turns the bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus. He also mentioned it's not in the epiclesis, it's also animiclesis. I hope I got the word right. He said it comes from the word amnesia, to forget. But here it's the opposite. Jesus said, do this in remembrance. He said, at that moment, in every Eucharist, the whole of creation, everyone who ever lived, everyone who's going to ever live, all my ancestors, all of the people in my family who have died, the apostles and the saints, all come together at that Eucharistic table at that moment. Yes, that is the wonder of the Eucharist. And I would like to end with Deuteronomy chapter 5 verses 12 to 13. The Lord says this, observe the Sabbath day and keep it holy, as the Lord your God has commanded you. For 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath for the Lord your God. The first, the beginning, the first day of the week and not the weekend. Amen.
My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me.